one really doesn't know what to say at a time like this. When you look through that list of people who have received the Pace Setter Award, it's a very distinguished list of past recipients, and I feel very humbled to be considered part of that list. First of all, I'd like to thank the community for the support that we've had through the museum, for our school system, for all the projects that I've worked on. They've been very easy to work on with the support that I've had from so many people. Also, particularly want to thank my wife, Nancy, and our two children, because these different projects have taken me away a lot, and they've been very supportive and helpful in that regard. And over the last couple of months, I've had a few people ask me when I was going to retire from the museum. Let me say, with two children in college, I don't think that's anytime soon. But very honored to receive this award, and thank the Chamber very much for that. Thank you.
Cindy's an MR in New York carrying on the work of the museum. She wants to simply congratulate Henry Sweets on being named the recipient of the Chamber's Pace Setter Award for the year 2010. How wonderful and how appropriate that Henry is receiving this well-deserved honor in the year of Mark Twain. January marks Henry's 32nd year at the museum, and I speak from personal experience when I say Henry has clearly made his mark upon the museum, upon Hannibal, and upon the rest of the world. Cindy goes on to talk about what Henry typically does in a day, from meeting with very important people, to people on the street, to fixing the roof, to opening windows, whatever needs to be done. And whew, what a typical day for Henry, it says. Of course, in between, he serves as a curator. Somehow he does it and finds time to catalog artifacts, present new exhibits, preserve and grow them. His famous "give me a minute" response is literal. He can put his hands on a primary source in lightning time. In my quickest calculation, I would say, conservatively speaking, Henry has set up approximately 12 million folding chairs and answered twice as many Twain-related questions. 2 years ago, a former teacher established a named endowment in Henry's honor. He has served as school board president, played summer softball, and has been involved in his church, raised two wonderful children, Amy and Henry IV, along with his wife, Nancy. She talks about his uncanny ability to anticipate the needs of others, his common sense approach to problem solving, and just his genuine way. She's writing these words from Twain's summer home in Elmira, a place she truly would not be if it weren't for Henry's support and encouragement.